Bonsoir. Je suis tellement heureuse de vous voir. Oh, excuse me. I was thinking of something else. Folks, you're gorgeous. You're treasured friends. Caring for me has kept me around. Much older than any of you. Much older. But I have to lean on your shoulder. Okay? Let me lean on your shoulder. And it's just amazing how you have not forsaken the road we've taken. Temple Israel was my second home. Growing up, we lived four blocks away. I was a 10-year-old walking to Sunday school, but I was mindful of the buildings with signs on them saying restricted clientele, no Jews, no dogs. And then Temple Israel became my sanctuary. She reminded me. And with opening doors to equality. However, anti-Semitism and segregation ran rampant.
Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness, hide any trace of sadness, although a tear may be ever so near, that's the time.
In 1949, we all went to Paris, didn't we? Because we're there tonight. And it was 4 years after the war. The boulevards were dim lit. The food rationing consisted of horse meat twice a week. Paris was an eternal beauty. And what amazed me was that in my classes, there were students of every race and color. And that's the way it was in Paris. And so when I came back a year later, I realized I could not teach in segregation.
Light up your face with gladness. Hide any trace of sadness. Although a tear may be smile.
I just wanted to pay a memory to my husband, Arnold, who was my inspiration and support, and later on to a very fine companion, Aaron Schechter, and their and his surrogate daughters, Lori and Julie, who were responsible for the film. Wait a minute. If I did not mention you in praise, would you please stand? Okay. I guess that's enough. Yeah, that's enough.
To be the man I used to be. Fascinating rhythm, oh, won't you stop picking on me?
I became a part of the Fine Arts Conservatory, I guess about seventh grade. It took a while to determine what instrument I could play that I should be introduced to. And finally, they settled on the cello.
I was lucky enough that when I was around 12 years old, she offered to give me 6 piano lessons. Through Ruth's influence and her wonderful aura and everyone else around her, I am now involved with the arts, and I would say I'm probably the reason why I'm at New World School of the Art.
I've known Ruth since I was 15 years old, when she first offered me a scholarship to go and attend Brevard Music Center, and then she offered me a scholarship to go to Tanglewood Music Center, and then I got married and had kids, and now she's been offering scholarships to all of my children. It just never stops. It's just been a wonderful journey knowing her.
James is now 83 and has been Ruth's student for nearly 70 years.
Good evening, everyone. I must confess that I feel very privileged tonight to be here with all of you to celebrate our friend, the one and only, my very dear friend and former colleague, Ruth Greenfield. I met Ruth exactly on 1971. Ever since, I have never ceased to be amazed by this wonderful lady. Ruth taught me so many things and was so instrumental in allowing Miami-Dade College to be such a great catalyst for everything good that happens in this community. Because Ruth had the strong, deep feeling that the arts could be such a wonderful way of bringing people together and bringing about change. All the work that she did and crossing the racial lines to be able to bring people together in search of social justice. But her work at Miami-Dade College, I think, cannot be underestimated, because you have to think, transport yourself back to the late 60s, early 70s, where in most cities in America, including Miami, people left downtown, and that's how the suburbs of Miami-Dade County were created. Downtown Miami was totally desolated, and you would be afraid to be in downtown Miami after 4 or 5 o'clock in the evening. The college felt an obligation to be downtown and bring and start a campus downtown, simply because the strong belief that we had that you could not have a successful city without a vibrant, dynamic downtown. And I'm glad we did, because you see the results today. The college has been acknowledged as the most important catalyst in the development of downtown Miami. And I have to say that a lot of that has to do with what Ruth was able to do through not just the Lunchtime Lively Art Series, because Ruth was such a brave, such a leader, such a pioneer, about to get to talk to the politicians to close the streets, Flagler Street, to bring about full orchestras, going and closing the street to bring people to the steps of the courthouse, and have so many wonderful, talented people from all over the country come to Miami to perform. And not only those people, but she encouraged young talent to be recognized, and she brought them on stage too. And that made such a big, big difference. And I always felt very privileged to be able to know Ruth and learn from her. As you know, she's very persistent. It's hard to say no to Ruth. She's fearless. I would say that she's tireless and relenting. And one thing you all need to know, that you don't want to pick a fight with Ruth. Because I assure you that that is something you'll never win, that fight. But on the other hand, one of the things that characterizes Ruth is the fact that she has a heart of gold. She really cares about people, and she really cares about humanity. She was, and still is, one of our most distinguished humanities professor at the college. And we all adore her, because she has taught so many generations of people who today are successful, who today are some of the leaders in Miami, and who make significant contributions, not just in the world of the arts, but in every other profession. So I'm gonna stop right here, but I just want you to know that I am so appreciative to be here with you, demonstrated our love for this very, very special person, that we all love you and applaud you.
Berachok mivnini mikro, her precious life is like a jewel. A jewel.
Folks, this occasion is the creation of our stellar new and esteemed rabbi, Amy Morrison. And the invaluable vice president of development, and also of the South Florida Symphony Orchestra, Mark Dedlin, and as the Rolls Royce of photography, Michael Todd. Everybody who has been making tributes, I make your tribute back. I cannot get over this evening. It's going to make me live to be 97.
What? Have a sing-along.
All right.
Getting to know all about you, da la 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 la, my cup of tea.
Put your hand up if you know the words.
Of all the beautiful and new things I
Thank you. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for this evening. Thank you.